here's what happens when you get really anxious. Your breathing gets really shallow. It looks like this. All right, I'm getting a little lightheaded there. This triggers the sympathetic nervous system. Blood rushes to your muscles, maybe you feel some butterflies in your stomach, your pupils dilate, your focus becomes really fine. That's what the sympathetic nervous system does. It's changing what's going on in your body to prepare yourself for potential dangerous situations. But if you're someone who really struggles with anxiety, all those sensations can be a bit overwhelming. That's where the parasympathetic nervous system comes in. The parasympathetic nervous system is responsible for calming down your body, undoing all that anxiety. And there's actually a shortcut to triggering it. Deep diaphragmatic breathing. Instead of taking shallow breaths from your chest, what you're actually going to be doing is taking deep breaths from your diaphragm. That's the thing right behind your belly button. When you're doing deep diaphragmatic breathing, your belly goes out when you inhale, and then you slowly exhale, lowering your belly. This is really hard to learn at first, so easy way to do it is by taking an object, maybe like a book, and put it on your belly. Just practice lifting it and lowering it. This will get you in the habit of just knowing what it feels like to use your diaphragm. Then keep the object there and practice breathing in as your belly goes up, and then slowly exhaling as your belly goes down. Probably want to practice this laying down on the floor or maybe your bed at first. It's a little bit easier to use your diaphragm that way. Once you get really good at this, you can move up to practicing it when you're sitting in a chair and then standing. If you're having trouble with your sinuses, you can also do this using pursed lips, almost like you're breathing through a straw and taking a slow inhale. As a New Yorker, I often tell kids to think about this as pizza breathing. Imagine you got a nice, fresh slice of pizza in front of you and you're taking a slow inhale like you're smelling it. Your belly goes out because you're so hungry, and then you slowly breathe out, cooling down the slice. There are similar forms of breathing involved in yoga and meditation, and what they all have in common is a slow breath. When do you use diaphragmatic breathing? Well, it's recommended to do it periodically in the day. The more you do deep diaphragmatic breathing, the more calm you're gonna feel. Now, I don't want you to start using this immediately when you're in very anxiety-provoking situations. If you haven't mastered it and then you try using it when you're highly anxious, it's probably not gonna work and you're gonna feel like a failure. The other thing is we don't want this to become a safety behavior. Safety behaviors are things you have to do, otherwise you can't go through the situation. Like maybe you have a fear of being in an elevator, but you're okay being in an elevator with a partner or a friend. If deep diaphragmatic breathing is the only way you can be in an elevator, then you haven't really overcome your fear. One more situation where you don't want to use deep diaphragmatic breathing: if you're at risk for fainting, diaphragmatic breathing is going to calm your body, lower your blood pressure. And if you're at risk for having a vasovagal fainting response, diaphragmatic breathing could make you more likely to faint. So don't do it then. Check out the link in the description below for an audio file that has a much longer guided version of deep diaphragmatic breathing. Have you ever used diaphragmatic breathing or similar types of deep breathing? Let me know in the comments below. I'm at Ali Mattu on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Be sure to like The Psych Show on Facebook and subscribe on YouTube.